How you doing? I bet you never thought, didn't expect to see that intro again. The Revenge Killer series is back for one more final segment, and the target is no other than the man who needs absolutely no introduction whatsoever. Blazing Kicking Chicken, aka BKC. This will go down as one of the greatest battles ever to be on this channel, and it's also my very late 500 subscriber special. Have to give some background first. This match took place the week before Smoke on Tour 14 started. And anyone that saw the last Wi-Fi battle will notice that when this battle starts, it looks like I'm facing Troll Monchan. But that's because Troll had to basically ghost for BKC, which basically means BKC just picks the moves and Troll does them. But it makes things interesting because Troll has seen the team I'm using, but BKC hasn't. So this can either turn out really good for me or really, really bad. But anyway, let's get into it. I lead with Gallade, he leads with Gliscor. Gliscor is naturally faster, but I'm thinking he's going to switch anyway because BKC knows what Lee Gallade does, and if he doesn't switch, Ice Punch plus Shadow Sneak will KO. Despite this, I go for Ice Punch anyway. I'm thinking he has either Skarm or Gare, but there's no reason to take risk on turn 1. He U-turns and reveals a Skarm. I'm still thinking he's running Lee Gliscor with Stealth Rock. The damage Skarm took tells me he's likely specially defensive. Just seeing these two on his team tells me he's either running Stall or at the very least Semi-Stall. Regardless, I'm going to Fortress because I need to keep spikes to a minimum. He actually switches as well and reveals a Rotom Cut, possibly expecting close combat so he can force Gallade out. This turn was scary because I had no idea what set he could be running. I was also trying to figure out why he'd be running the Cut form since Rotom Wash was still extremely popular. Didn't figure it out until after the match, but I'm terrified of Will-O-Wisp here since it'd be nice to hit this thing hard with Payback as the match goes on, but I finally decided to just risk it, set up Stealth Rock. He actually switches to reveal Heatran. Seeing Gliscor, Skarm, Rotom, and now Heatran, it's time to start formulating a plan as to how I'm going to win. But now that Heatran's out, I realize it's possible that Heatran could be the rocker. I decide to reveal Gyarados since I know either Stealth Rock or Fire Move is coming. He does reveal Stealth Rock, so that means Gliscor is the standard Stallbreaker. Thinking to go for Taunt or Waterfall, I initially thought Heatran could have Explosion and that he might use it here since Heatran could be carrying Passion Berry, but after looking at his team, I realize it's likely specially defensive. He normally doesn't carry Explosion, so he'll probably switch. I decide on Waterfall to try and catch Rotom, but he reveals a Starmie. Seeing Leftovers tells me it's a Rapid Spinner variant. I don't want to assume it's the standard set, though. He could have Hydro Pump. So I thought about Jolteon, but if he predicts a switch and uses a Water Stab, Jolteon takes half. So regardless, I've seen five of his guys. I'm guessing his last is Tyranitar, so it looks like Stall, and now my focus is on a Gyarados sweep. I just need to keep it healthy and KO Rotom to win. I'm thinking he'll spin, but I go to Fortress in case of Thunderbolt. He surprisingly went back to Skarm. Either he was predicting Gallade or he was scouting the Gyarados set. It's a bad matchup for him. I decided to go for Rapid Spin, knowing he has Rotom. He does go to it, but I really just wanted to see what item Rotom had, since it will now take Stealth Rock damage coming in. I also wanted to play Obvious right now, so I could hopefully spring Payback on a predicted switch to Rotom later in the match. He doesn't show Leftover, so I'm thinking it's Scarf. I take inventory here. He knows I got Stealth Rock, Rapid Spin, and Lefties on 4A. Flygon's not going to be able to do much unless Starmie goes away, since I don't know if it has Ice Beam or not. I just show Payback, and he switches back to Heatran. He does show Leftovers, confirming that he's specially defensive. And I'm thinking of what else he could possibly have. Will-O-Wisp was possible, so I want to scout for that, as well as Earth Power. The plan is to go to Jolteon first to scout for Will-O-Wisp, since nothing else appreciates a burn, then go to Gallade to scout for Earth Power and force Heatran out. So I'm going to go to...
That boy good! That boy real good!
He goes back to Starmie, though, expecting Gyarados to come in since that's what I switched into train the first time. I want to preserve Gyarados though and not take meaningless Stealth Rock damage until I can spin or kill Rotom. So no epic prediction on my end. BKC's in a bad spot again. I start thinking what else he could have on Gliscor at this point. I'm thinking he must have Toxic, but I could be wrong. Because of Gliscor, Thunderbolt's too obvious, so I reluctantly show that I'm running Wish Jolteon. I say reluctantly because Troll has seen me use this set, so I was hoping he wouldn't predict. He doesn't, makes the safe play to Heatran since I could predict Gliscor and throw Hidden Power Ice, possibly. Fortress and Gyarados are too important for this match, so I can't risk them getting burned by Will-O-Wisp. I consider Gallade and run some Calcs. Gallade will only die if Heatran has Flamethrower, so I stick with the plan I came up with earlier and go to him. He shows that he has Roar, which tells me he most likely doesn't have Earth Power, so Jolteon's a fairly safe switch into Heatran. Four gets pulled in, but it's not a big deal. But without Spikes down, BKC's not going to get much mileage out of spamming Roar. Plus, two-thirds of my team will force Heatran out. Regardless, I have to switch again since I can't risk losing Fortress until Skarmory is gone, and I spun all hazards off my side of the field if he gets to lay them. Now that I know Jolteon is a safe switch, I decide to go back to...
That boy good! Did he say one move?
Yeah, he said
one move! Crazy, man!
I gotta go to the bathroom! since I can mitigate some of the Stealth Rock damage with Wish if he decides to spam Roar. He switches back to Starmie again though, confirming that he's been looking for Gyarados to come in, since it's a threat to his team. The safest place is just Wish again. If he stays in the Surf, then I can show Protect and heal Jolteon back to full if nothing else. If he switches, then I can consider passing Wish to something else. He does switch back to Heatran. I know he most likely doesn't have Earth Power, otherwise he would have used it already. Because of that, I don't want to show Protect yet. I want to give as little information about Jolteon as possible, but just in case, I count the damage Earth Power would do, and it's actually not a one-hit KO, so I show Thunderbolt instead. Figuring if Gliscor comes in, then I can go to Flygon since I don't want Gyarados catching Stealth Rock damage and Toxic, and Flygon can at least Roost to limit Toxic damage. He goes back to Rotom though, surprisingly, but I appreciate any damage I get on it. I don't want Jolteon getting tricked. I can either Protect or go to 4-8, and I don't really want to do the latter. If I do, he could predict by double switching to Heatran, which I'm fine with, since 4-8 doesn't get tricked, and I could just go back to Jolteon since I deduced that he most likely just has Lava Plume, but Jolteon and Gallade are the least important, but they're still useful currently. Also, BKC needs spikes up, so Skarm has to come in sooner or later. I just keep it simple. The plan was to just Protect, then go to 4-8 if he tricks, but he went back to Tran. I revealed Protect needlessly, and this was the moment of truth to see if he actually had Earth Power. I stayed into Wish in his face after calculating how much Lava Plume does. He does show Lava Plume, confirming that there is no Earth Power, but does more than I thought, so he either rolled max damage or he's got some special attack EVs, and I got a nasty burn too. At least it was Jolteon though, rather it be him than anyone else. I'm sure BKC knows by now that Gyarados and 4-8 are really big problems to him if he hadn't realized it earlier, but I can't keep playing defense because Jolteon won't be able to Wish Pass forever now that it's taking damage. I'll need to be aggressive eventually. Gallade is now essentially switch fodder, reasons being are that BKC will probably Roar Spam again, and Gallade is at less than 50% now, so it can throw 4 attacks at most because of Life Orb. I decide to go to Gallade, he does Roar, Jolteon does get dragged back in, and here I just decide to just Wish again, just to scout. Seems like the whole time he's been scouting my set and is now playing mind games by alternating between Lava Plume and Roar. And he is going to go for the Lava Plume again, but now I'm not going to be able to keep Jolteon alive, even by Wish Protecting, because of the burn. I also realized that Heatran has been slowly but surely negating the damage I've done to it every turn through leftovers. So this turn coming up, I am predicting him to Roar, expecting me to switch out, so I'm gonna go for Thunderbolt to at least get Heatran back to the health it was at before, and he is gonna end up Roaring, and Flygon actually gets revealed, which I'm actually pretty happy about, because now what I want to do is plant in his mind that I'm using the most common set for Flygon, which is Choice Scarf, since he hasn't seen any Scarfers yet. I know he has Protect as his last move, but I go for Earthquake anyway, and he does go for the Protect. But now, the plan here is I'm going to switch out and just proceed with the Bluff. Deciding who to switch to, though, was tough. Jolteon can't come back in, but if I choose Jolteon, then I can't use it as Death Fodder later to block Rapid Spin from Starmie. But I do ultimately decide on Jolteon, knowing that he'll either switch or attack, giving me momentum either way. I'll just need to keep Starmie off the field. He goes to Gliscor, and I move accordingly by going to 4-8 to keep Skarm and Starmie out. This is a bit of a tough turn here, since I can go a few different ways. I could go to Flygon now, I could spin away Stealth Rock, or I could payback predicting him to go to Rotom to block the spin. I decide on the second choice to enforce that I'm making the obvious play by spinning like I did earlier. He goes to Tran, possibly predicting payback from me so I could catch Rotom on the switch. I don't want to spring the trap yet, though. Taking the risk by spinning paid off since I'm forcing him to make a tough decision here. He won't Roar or Protect since they don't benefit him. He'll either attack or put up Stealth Rock again. As easy as it is to go to Gyarados, I don't want it getting burned. Otherwise, everything I've done will be for nothing, even though Stealth Rock's off the field now. Also, Starmie would easily come in on Gyarados and just spin, and I don't want to do anything that'll force me to reveal my last, so I need to just roll with the 4 guys I've got versus his 5. I end up choosing Flygon. Worst case scenario is he gets burned, but it's mixed, so it still isn't useless. He sets up Stealth Rock again, and which is good since Flygon limits his options on who he can switch in. I'm going to go for Earthquake again, forcing the issue and the earlier bluff, but he goes directly to Skarmory to get some hazards going. This turn is crucial in getting him to think I'm Scarfed. I know he's going to set up Spikes, but I have to let him and hope I can get 4-8 and spin them away later. I intentionally Earthquake, to really give him that false sense of security and get him to think I was trying to catch him on a double switch to Heatran. But thinking I've got him now, it's time to spring the trap, and I have to hope I don't miss. So I show that I do have Fire Blast and that I am mixed. He does end up staying in, it hits. I also get a burn for all my hard work, and Skarm still lives the Fire Blast, even after the burn, thanks to the leftovers recovery. I was a bit shocked, but then I realized he has to be running a careful nature with max special defense. He gets a second layer down, which is very bad for me, but this is my only chance to take Skarm out. If I switch, he'll just roost off the damage and I'm really in trouble. So I go for the most accurate move I have, Draco Meteor. He stays in, thankfully it hits. Skarm going down is big, since it now opens Tyranitar up to sweep. It even opens up Gallade for what it's worth. But he reveals his last, which is Tyranitar. I was honestly expecting Rotom or Starmie to come in. That means activating Gliscor's Sand Veil was inevitable, since that was also something I was trying to avoid all game. Thinking he's banded here since Rotom was Scarfed, which the only switch I have for that is Fortress. But after seeing that my other team members can take care of whatever Flygon can, I stay in. But he outspeeds me and shows Ice Beam, one-shotting Flygon. I was totally floored. And now I've lost one of my best Gliscor switch-ins, so he's running two Scarfers. And I asked BKC at this point if Gliscor is a big issue for his team, but he gave me several other reasons why he runs Ice Beam on Scarfitar, so I approved. Flygon still did her job regardless. I don't know what else that Tyranitar could be carrying, so I went to Fortress, and it's here that I decided to spring the next trap. Seeing that there were two layers of spikes down, I figured BKC would predict me to get desperate and spin immediately by going to Rotom, since he sees that my team doesn't like spikes. But I go for payback and nail Rotom on the switch, KOing it after sand damage. And he's going to bring Heatran in to force me out, but now Fori can spin whenever whenever she wants to. Except in this situation, Gallade can't sweep now because of a Scarfitar, so I'll have to use it as switch fodder in case he roars. If he lava plumes, then Gallade dies and I get a free switch. If he switches, then I can get Fori in on whatever he goes to and spin. He roars, which is expected now that he has hazards down. My own Tyranitar finally gets revealed. I stay in an earthquake to either hit Heatran, Tyranitar, or Starmie. I figured if he goes to Gliscor, then I'm forced to reveal my set. He ends up staying in to fodder Heatran and scout my set. I immediately realize that his Starmie could have Hydro Pump if he chooses to bring it in, so I count the damage as this is going on, and Tyranitar can take one in the sand to Dragon Dance in its face if I have to. But he's going to end up choosing Tyranitar though. And I take a look here to see who I need the most. I need Gyarados and Tyranitar. Gallade is the best switch at this point, since he could double switch to Starmie predicting Gyarados, and he could use Fori as an opportunity to do something else. So I go to Gallade to Death Fodder and see what T-Tar locks into, which turns out to be a superpower. Now, even though Gallade did nothing offensively, he was extremely useful this match when it came to using it to switch into situations like the roar spamming that was going on. I ultimately go to Fori to take advantage and get off a spin after calculating the damage it would take from the hazards followed by a superpower. Turns out Fori would live just barely. I have to spin here no matter what, otherwise T-Tar isn't sweeping. If he stays in, I'll sack Fori after the spin, then go to Gyarados to set up. He needs to keep his hazard, so BKC makes a good call here by going to Gliscor in an attempt to block Rapid Spin through Sand Veil. Unfortunately, it does not kick in and he loses his hazards. And with Skarm and Tran gone, he won't be able to get hazards back up for the rest of the game. BKC pointed out that he didn't expect DDTar to be my last, but I can't bring either of my other guys in since Gliscor is faster than both of them unboosted and he can taunt or toxic them, potentially stopping the sweep. I have to hold my ground here with Fortress and hope to at least get enough damage on it to where Gyarados can finish Gliscor off. He taunts first to stop any more shenanigans since he hasn't seen my last move and I pay back. I calc the damage Earthquake would do. I don't even want to switch between Fori and Gyarados to weaken EQ since it's not worth it this late in the game. I can take two at the most before going down, and I plan to end the show big time before I do. I keep throwing payback just to keep Starmie out of the mix, but I miss the second one, and he goes for Earthquake again. This time he decided to taunt again, and he's probably trying to PP stall me out of payback so Starmie can come in and try to finish things up, but I know his last move is Roost, which he shows here. So Toxic is out, thankfully. He eventually does, he uses Roost. He then starts up the Earthquake cycle again. But this time around, it's pretty unfortunate because he's actually going to get a crit on this Earthquake. And that's going to land me at 89 HP after leftovers. So this is it. I do a calc. Earthquake maxes out at 90 damage. So on this next turn, he either needs to roll max damage on Earthquake or crit again. This time I'm just going to decide to show my trump card because I really don't have another choice at this point. So he goes for Earthquake. And I just barely live. I live with 7 HP. And I show my last move, Explosion. Nothing else matters now except this Explosion hitting through Sandvale, and it does. But not only does it hit, it actually KOs the Gliscor, which I wasn't looking for. But needless to say, when I saw this, I was like... Yes. So, it's a double down. I decide not to take any risk and switch Tyrantar in directly. If he brings in his own Tyrantar, I'll sack mine to get superpower to superpower to get a free DD with Gyarados and hopefully KO or cripple Starmie with bounce. He brings in Starmie though. That means I need to DD up in its face since Tyrantar can take one Hydro Pump from the spinner variant in the sand from full, barring a crit. He goes for it and no crit, so I get my Dragon Dance off to force the speed tie situation between my T-Tar and his T-Tar. I could easily go for Crunch, but he has Scarf Tar left, so I do a calc and see that plus one Earthquake is almost guaranteed to KO from where Starmie is at. So I'm going to go for it, just to keep BKC honest. And turns out I do manage to get the KO on his Starmie. So he's going to bring in his Tyranitar. This game is still not over yet, though. In this situation, I know BKC is going to lock in a Stone Edge. To hope to win the speed tie and get the KO on my T-Tar. If he does, then Gyarados is in trouble. But I go for Earthquake and I win the speed tie and the match with a very narrow 2-0. But this was an awesome game, BKC. Crazy predictions and thought processes on every turn from start to finish. This was yet another good indication of how to play against Stahl when using offense in 4th gen. Also have to give props for making the to BKC for making the finals in Smogon Tour 14, proof that the year of BKC is coming. Also guys, I did post my RMT for this team on Smogon, and I'll probably put it up on PO at some point, probably more sooner than later, but I'll leave a link in the description below. Feel free to check it out, guys. Leave a love disc if you actually like the team. But yeah, anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed that as much as I did. That was a hell of a match. The final battle is coming up, and we are reaching the end of the JackieChun saga. But until the last episode, guys, Chun is out. Peace.